the Muslims of these times, and especially those living in the West, we have a lot of problems. There are problems all over the world of different kinds, but as Muslims, our most important concern is our deen and our iman. Yes, we need food to eat, clothes to wear, water to drink, houses to live in, we need jobs, and we, like all other people, have all sorts of needs, but our main fundamental, most important need is to preserve our iman and to please Allah. Preserve, safeguard, protect your imans. And before you can protect your iman, you need to build your iman. Some people are coming into Islam, but many are standing on the verge of kufr so much that they are leaving Islam as well. And many people claim to be Muslims, but Allahu Akbar, but have no respect for Allah, no respect for Rasulullah, no respect for Islam. They are more concerned about pleasing the media and pleasing people at large. And they want to be more Western than the Western. And they want to be whiter than white. And they want to be more British and more English than the British and the English. And being Muslims, they want to be more Christian than even Christians. With Christmas coming up now, many people will be celebrating Christmas. But even many Christians do not celebrate Christmas because they know this is not when Jesus was born. Christian scholars themselves know Jesus was not born in the winter. He was born in spring. And the Quran says, Surah Maryam, if only you read, when Isa alayhi salam was about to be born, Maryam alayhi salam, she left the town and she went and she sought refuge under a palm tree. And Allah commanded her, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُتَبًا جَنِيًّا. Oh Maryam, shake the tree and then fresh dates will fall upon you. So Maryam alayhi salam, according to the Quran, she gave birth to Isa alayhi salam when there were fresh dates on palm trees. And that doesn't happen in December. That happens April, May, June. So that's the time Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was born. And many Christians don't celebrate Christmas in December. But many supposed Muslims now, they want to be more Christian than the even most committed Christians. And they expect Muslims to celebrate Christmas. Somebody sent me a text in one of the London local newspapers, a supposed Muslim by the name of Asif Mahmood. He wrote an article expressing his disgust at the fact that children who come to masjids are taught that Christmas is haram. What do you expect us to teach? Christmas is halal and you should go and celebrate Christmas? Is that why you send your children here to the masjid so that they can learn about Christmas and go home and celebrate Christmas? You might say, well, that's only one guy perhaps who's lost his nut a little bit. And he's saying, why are you telling us? It only takes one fish to spoil the whole pond. Few of the supposed Muslims who think they are more Christian than the Christians and more British than the British and whiter than the white who expect us all to celebrate Christmas. مَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ. Whosoever resembles any nation will become like them. So don't think just because you've got a Christmas tree in the home, what difference does it make? We are living in England, for God's sake. Yes, we are living in this society, multicultural society, integration. Our children, we go and work alongside Christians, Hindus. We don't cause problems. But your faith, that's your wealth. That is your personal affair. And you have to look after and preserve and safeguard your faith.